New questions today about cutting the budget in Washington. They come after former President Bill Clinton was caught on tape speaking backstage to Republican Congressman Paul Ryan, expressing support for Ryan's willingness to at least try to reform Medicare. Neither was aware that the camera was rolling. Take a listen. You'll see the former president in silhouette on the left of your screen, Congressman Ryan on screen right.
I'm glad we won this race in New York, but I hope the Democrats don't use it as an excuse to do nothing.
I guess it's going to sink into paralysis is what's going to happen. And you know the math. I mean, it's just we knew we were putting ourselves out there, but you got to start this. You got to get out there. You got to get this thing moving.
All right, let's talk about that moment and what it means with Simon Rosenberg, a former campaign advisor for President Clinton and president of the think tank NDN, and Ben Ferguson, a conservative radio host. Gentlemen, welcome to you both.
Good to be here.
Thanks for having us.
All right, Ben, I don't know that the Republicans can get too excited because once President Clinton hit the stage, he wasn't exactly endorsing Ryan's plan.
No, of course not, because this is one of those issues where fear-mongering seems to win. But Clinton understands what Paul Ryan understands, and that's why I was so candid behind stages. We know there's a problem with funding. We know we can't sustain it. So we have two options. We can either lie to you and tell you it's going to be okay and keep spending the way we are, and one day people are going to show up to their bank, and they're going to be out of money, and Medicare's not going to be there. Or we can try to reform it now. I mean, your options are go with what Clinton said on stage, which is the equivalent of what Bernie Madoff did to all those millionaires that gave him money, or do what he did backstage and say, we got to fix it because otherwise everybody's going to go broke eventually. I like Bill Clinton behind the curtain instead of the one in front of it.
All right, Simon, but some folks may like what he had to say on stage, which was this. He said the Democrats are going to have to be willing to give up maybe some short-term political gain by whipping up fears on some of these things if it's a reasonable Social Security proposal or a reasonable Medicare proposal. Now, does that hurt the current administration's efforts and what Democrats in the White House are trying to do with, you know, President Clinton suggesting maybe they do stop the fear-mongering and get to work?
I don't think anything that's happened in the last few months is fear-mongering. I think that what President Clinton said.
Jumping a woman off a cliff isn't fear-mongering?
Let Simon answer.
What President Clinton said, he's not very good at that, by the way, in general. But what President Clinton said was that, to Paul Ryan, if you put the two pieces together, what he said on stage and what he said backstage, was that, look, it's important we fix Medicare, but the way you went about it was wrong. I mean, what he said was people will use less, get sicker, and die quickly if we follow the Ryan plan. So there was no endorsement of what Ryan tried to do. And I think where Ryan and the Republicans have made a mistake is not in their desire to fix Medicare. It was the way they tried to do it, and which would have caused millions and millions of seniors to have much less care. It would have allowed millions of people to die more quickly, as the president said. And I think the debate
now,
I agree with the president, Ben, shut up. It's unbelievable how much you talk.
It's fear-mongering.
It's not fear-mongering. It's a factual, correct interpretation of the Ryan plan. The Ryan plan was bad public policy. It would have killed people prematurely. That's fact. So the point now is, how do we actually fashion a bipartisan solution to fix Medicare and put it on a better course? That's where the debate has to go. That's what the president was saying.
There is no debate, though, from your side. That's the problem. All you do is make commercials pushing an old woman off a cliff and saying that if you touch Medicare or Social Security, that you're going to kill old people like you just insinuated three different times. That's fear-mongering. You have no idea how to fix it.
Ben, I think the point is that the president... President Obama put forward a fiscal commission that has made very ambitious recommendations about how to put Social Security and Medicare on a more sound course. This idea that this president hasn't been a leader in this conversation is just wrong, right? The second thing is that his own proposal that he laid out three weeks ago. Guys, why should
the
I come on the show if I can't talk?
Ben, let's let Simon wrap up his answer.
Go ahead, Ben.
And then we'll come back to you.
Ben,
Simon,
everyone's dying to hear from you, Ben. Go ahead.
Simon, you finish up.
All right,
up.
The react.
Go ahead,
go
Simon.
Ahead, Ben. I'm not talking
anymore,
guys. All
right, good. The president, here's the reality. The president, you can pout, and that's what you guys do well at. But the president just had a proposal for a budget. They didn't get one Democrat to vote for it. So you can say the president of the United States of America wants to fix Social Security. You can say he wants to fix Medicare. He hasn't pushed that issue. He hasn't moved forward with it. He does not have support for it. And anytime anyone else comes to the table with an idea, you automatically say, and you walk off stage like you're doing now, because there is no compromise with Democrats. You're proving right now by walking off stage exactly why Medicare will not get fixed with Democrats in office, because when someone disagrees with you or says that you guys don't have a plan, you quit and you fearmonger and say people are going to die, and then you walk off stage, and that's the problem.
All right. Just so we're clear, you see the empty chair there. Simon Rosenberg has left this conversation, and we know that this is a topic that gets very heated, very ugly in Washington and around the country as we try to find some solutions. It's a difficult one. There are no easy solutions. Both sides know we're going to have to make sacrifices and do things. Ben, thank you. Simon, thank you. We hope you'll both come
back. Thanks for having me.
Thanks.